Bonjour monde,
which basically means hello world in French,
and welcome to the first English episode of this review series. In every episode of this review series, we will review three fascinating recently released websites, and in the second part of the video, I will record one of the best effects we found browsing them. A good opportunity for you to stay up to date with the last trends in web development, and of course, a very good way to learn how to code them. Wonderful! My name is Benjamin Code, I'm a French pro front-end developer with 10 years experience as a freelancer, so I think guys, I have a lot of things to share with you. So let's start. As we have three websites to analyze, let's not waste time and let's begin with the first one, which is Julia Johnson website. And let's first watch how the website reveals itself. It's quite interesting. It's not the hardest transition ever. It's really easy to code, but it works pretty well. It's like this orange curtains that reveals the website. And when you are in the website, there is some kind of disorder because you have this very big picture overlapping the title and you're like, what is this? So you want to scroll to reveal the title. It's a good invitation to travel in the website. I kind of appreciate it. And when you hover the image, you have this very interesting stuff. It's a very smart hover effect and you want to click. You really want to click. So congratulations for this creation. Apparently you can scroll forever, as you can see with this scroll bar getting bigger and bigger every time you scroll. And yeah, if you're really motivated, you can do this until your computer crash, but I don't think it's exactly what you want. And it's basically not what I want. So maybe I'm gonna stop and refresh the page to save some resources, because resources are really important. Save the planet, guys. Have an eco-browsing behavior. Before clicking on any images, I want to introduce my favorite effect of the website. Be ready, because it's gonna be pretty quick. I want you to notice it. Let's do it. You're here, you go here, you click. Boom! Did you see it? No? I asked you to be attentive and you didn't see it. So you are here, and you click here. And what I wanted you to notice is this button here. It is so smart. Here you have this menu burger. You know that it's a menu burger, but a strange one with two thick, very thick black bars. And you realize that the background was not a background. It was a line separating a square. And this line is changing into a cross. And I love this effect so much. I find it really smart and very cool. And if you want to train, you can reproduce this effect. For beginners, it will teach you a lot of things. So let's click here. And when you click, you can notice two things that I really appreciate. First of all, is the transition between two pages. You have to know that I love transition between pages. Here, it's a pretty simple one, but pretty efficient. It's fade in, fade out. Look, fade in, fade out, fade in. But it works really well because when you are here, you have this army of colorful placeholders that works pretty well. You are here, you click, and you have all these placeholders with all different heights, and then the images comes and loads inside, and that works pretty well, especially with the fact that you have always the main color of the image inside the placeholder, and this is something I really appreciate. And also the pictures, they are all so cool. Look at this one, look at this lady. And it also gives us the occasion to explore the gallery and to see how the gallery is built. You click and you start to realize one thing, is the images never take the same place in the gallery. And I really like this effect because it gives you the impression to be inside a wide cube exhibition, and you can find many pictures on the walls. And especially I'm going to show you my favorite picture of the set, which is this one. And Julia, if you want to send me this picture for my flat in Malaga, leave a comment under the video and I will give you my address. Don't worry about this. So, you know what you have to do if you want to make me happy. So that's all for this first website. The second website we want to visit is nolook.co.japan. What's going on here? This is what's going on. This is the most incredible effect I have seen lately on the landing page. I really appreciate it. Just HTML, JavaScript, CSS, it's really elegant. It's super smart. I have no idea how they did it right now, but it's definitely the effect I want to call at the end of this video. So if you appreciate this effect, you will be able to see me in the second part, recode it from scratch. So stay around here and you will discover some pretty interesting things. So now let's jump to the third and last one. The name is Gucci Osteria. You have these three images revealing themselves in this kind of doors or windows. I don't know exactly what it is, but it's super cool because it's a very easy effect to code. It's like a box with the big border radius for the left and right corner of the top. But it's really interesting because there is a physical and a real world sense here. You are here, you are like at the entrance, and you have to choose which door you're gonna take. Let's go to the donut part, to Italia and Florence. Muy bien. It's Spanish, it's no Italian, sorry. You arrive just here, and again, this kind of door effect with the title overlapping it, I really appreciate it. And also, I appreciate the structure of the whole website with this kind of line, and it gives me a good feeling of structuration, like the plates are going to be well structured in this restaurant. So let's scroll and let's discover what this website has for us. So you have a smooth scroll, I like it. Okay. Every element reveal themselves with a cool sliding up transition. And here you have the team. So you have the chief here, Karim Lopez. And before this website, I didn't know that Karim was also a name for girls. I thought it was only for guys. Never met a girl named Karim. So nice to meet you, Chief Karim. And I have to confess, I really want to discover your cuisine. As a French person, I'm really interested in cuisine. I would easily get into a plane to visit you and taste your cuisine. So hello, Karim again. Let's click. And when we click, we discover that we have this kind of transition between two pages again. And I don't quite like this one. This kind of potato coming from the bottom of the page and morphing into the wall page and then going out. We saw it a lot of time, and again with this kind of color scheme, I don't like it too much. But here, this menu, look at this over effect. So cool. What is the tasting menu? This is the menu I really would like to enjoy in your restaurant, Karim. Wow, it looks so good. Cucumis mellow, purple coal, tostada, under the sea. Gadus, I think it's a beef. Gadus, and bloom and rebloom. Oh my god. This one, the Renaissance chapter, I really want to test it. Really, really. Leave a comment, Karim, under the video. So, it was the third website, and now we are gonna jump to the recording of this effect that we appreciated so much. I chose to reproduce this effect, but before I start doing this one, I would like to mention that you can also learn a lot by trying to reproduce one of the following. The first one, really cool, right? The second one, that we really appreciate also. And of course, this last one. If you recreate one of them, ping me on Twitter with the hashtag BenjaminCodeReview and I will check it and retweet it to inspire others. So let's go. There are a lot of magic here and I have no idea for now about how to code it. So let's start by analyzing the effect. If we look closely and slowly, we can notice the different layers and small things we are going to need. First, a box containing the image and moving with the mouse. Second, an image inside the box, moving just on the horizontal axis and staying inside the box no matter what. And third, a kind of shadow that follows the movement of the box, but with a kind of latency and deceleration that we will call a ease effect. Easing. So we will have basically three elements to focus on, and of course, they will all react to the mouse moves. That sums up basically the ecosystem of this effect. We will not reproduce the title effect by lack of time. Let's first add the box and the image inside the box. Some very basic HTML stuff here. And I know, this picture is super weird. It was a joke with the chat, so if you want to understand the jokes with the chat, then subscribe to my Twitch channel and come to watch the next live. Then you will understand. So let's quickly position the box and the image in the middle of the screen with a little bit of CSS. For now, it's almost all for the HTML and CSS part. The rest of the magic is going to come with JavaScript. And with JavaScript, the first thing we have to find out is a good way to use the position of the mouse. In the creative coding world, what we usually like to do when we code some JavaScript effect is to get numbers between -1 and 1. For now, we have the position of the mouse between 0 and the width of the window, but we are gonna use some trivial mathematical formula to change them to -1 and 1, where -1 will represent the left border of the screen, 0 the middle, and finally 1 the right border of the screen. And it's done! Nice! With the -1 to 1 range, we can code way much easily so many different effects, and here, This is what we are going to do to add some translation to our image to finally start to see the effect taking shape. We just update the CSS transform of our box and we use the Translate 3D because the Translate 3D is better handled by your GPU. Olé! Let's do this for the Y-axis now and we'll be good. Okay, it's working well. For now, we were only moving the image inside the box. Let's also move the box with a different speed to have this cool parallax effect. And for you to realize where is the box, I just put it in pink for now. Yay! Now it's working! The box and the image are moving together. The effect is slowly and slowly taking shape. Now that this thing is moving quite okay, I want to add the shadow. The shadow will just be a block, a div, with the same width and height as our box, and just behind it, copying its coordinates with a small delay and deceleration, so with the easing. For this, we are going to use a request frame animation function, and we are going to put some lerp function to stimulate this delay. When we are at it, let's also use this lerp technique to have smoother movement for our image and our box. Lerp functions are the basis of all kind of movements. All the websites you see that look smooth to your eyes with some kind of easing effect everywhere usually use lerp functions. It is a little bit too complex to address that in this video, but keep the keyword in mind if one day you have to make a similar effect. Or you can also use a library like JSAP to have this kind of easy movement. Here in my case, I didn't want to import such a huge library while a one-line lerp function was doing the job really fine. In the end, we fine-tuned some parameters to get a good feeling movement, we changed the color of the shadow to match a color in the image, and we are done with this effect. Hallelujah! It was so interesting. So to conclude, tell me in the comment what point you would like I spend more time on in the future. And because for today, that's all I have for you in this video. I will release one video like this every 1 or 2 weeks. So if you like it, consider to subscribe so you won't miss the next ones. It was Benjamin Code for his first English video on his channel. All the coming video will be in English now, so I hope to see you next time. It was really important for me to open myself to the whole world, and even if I shit my pants doing this switch, I think it's a good thing to do. Future will tell. Ciao.